Hi.
Hello.
안녕하세요. This would be my first ever talking video on YouTube. So, to start this video, I will introduce myself first. My name is Sarah Sofia, also known as Matcha Green Tea on TikTok. I think a lot of you guys may know me from TikTok. Yesterday, I posted a video of me having a conversation with a Korean using the phone.
안녕하세요.
안녕하세요. 아니요. 인사밖에 안 했어요.
인사만 해도 들어보면 알아요.
감사합니다. 조금 할 수 있어요.
발음이 엄청 좋으세요.
시청자 수가 50만 명 넘었어요. 재밌게 봐주셔서 너무 감사하고요. 제가 원래 유튜브를 진짜 많이 하고 싶었거든요. 근데 기회가 없었고 태클에서 많은 분들이 저에게 어떻게 한국어 배우냐고 많이 물어봤는데 이제 영상으로 알려줄게요. 제가 어떻게 녹화하는 방법이 지금 알려드릴게요. I don't know if people will watch this video, but I will just do this video to start my YouTube channel. So yeah, Korean learning journey. You guys might start with Boys Over Flower. I started with Descendant of the Sense. It was around 2017 and 2018 where I started to googling everything about Korean language. And the reason why I want to learn Korean, I just simply want to know what they're saying. I was like challenging myself to learn another language because at that time at school, I was learning Japanese. So if I dahta ho Japanese, then why not Korean? I'm not a pro yet. I don't have a topic certificate. I am intermediate learner. I am able to do daily conversation. I think, but there are still a lot more words or phrases that I still don't know. Today, I will share how I self-learned Korean. I will just share what I did to learn Korean. Maybe you guys can follow this way, but if you guys are so good, then you guys can use other way too. I made a whole list. For the Hangul letters, I Google how to see they look like. Of course, Google is my number one source. You can just Google anything though because Google has everything. Just Google Hangul letters and you can dia akan keluar a lot. Click on random website and think wala how the letters look like. While for YouTube, I go to see how they write the Hangul letters and how to pronounce the right way. Korean has the right mouth shape to pronounce the letters, so I recommend you going to YouTube. There are a lot of free videos that will show you that. I found Duolingo and LingoDear. These apps are like quiz-based apps. The question will be there and you can answer A, B, or C, or D. So it helps you memorize. To master the Hangul letters, I do write random K-pop names and city. We have a lot of members, so I just write their names every day to practice my writing. On to the next step. For reading, I know that I need to read a lot. Hangul characters at that time was really really confusing. Sometimes N like this, D good like that. What I did for reading, I will follow a lot of idols on Instagram, right? You guys pun follow kan? I just read everything off their caption. I read their caption without knowing the meaning. It's okay if you don't know the meaning at first because you're still learning. We're still learning. For improving reading juga, I sing K-pop song along with Korean lyrics. I know you guys, if you guys don't know Korean, you akan pergi dekat YouTube and go search for the romanization, right? Please don't do that. What I did, open Spotify and I start with slow-paced songs, ballad songs like... Just go with slow-paced songs so that you can quote all the syllables. If you dah master the slow song, you challenge yourself with fast-paced songs. I did that maybe every day at least for one song. Simplest, easiest thing to do, which is I watch a lot of K-drama and variety shows, K-pop videos a lot. Of course, they're talking in Korean. And what I did, I just think, oh, every day. I pause while watching K-drama and I follow anything they said. Just do it naturally. Lakun semula apa yang diorang cakap. That helps untuk pronunciation. You tengok drama and then dia cakap benda lah tu. You pun ikut. Just buat tu. Her variety show, Korean shows is like they show the spoken Korean every day kan. Daily conversation diorang every day. So you just have to follow sebab akan cakap bahasa or style yang diorang cakap dekat TV tu juga. Variety shows that I can recommend yang I tengok. For K-drama, I use Netflix Learning Language. Netflix Learning Language ni Chrome extension. You can just download it from Chrome and it will connect to your Netflix. When you are watching K-drama, they are talking in Korean kan. Korean sub dekat bawah, English sub dekat atas. That really helps improve reading juga. I do 혼자 말. 혼자 is alone, 말 is speaking. So I speak alone.
Yes, it's the process of learning. I do 혼자말 a lot. I try to talk to myself in Korean. That will challenge your mind to think in Korean though. I actually dream, 민피 in Korean. And bila I bangun, I macam, did I just speak Korean in my dream? I think it happened like twice or three times now. Just go and speak Korean to yourself every day. 디도 유아카 민피 in Korean. So you can try talking to yourself in front of the mirror. Just try thinking, oh, 오늘 뭐 먹을까? 오늘 점심 뭐 먹을까? You ask yourself in Korean. After mastering all your Hangul letters, it's time for grammar and vocabularies. Vocabularies, I mostly got it from watching K-drama and variety shows. I find online website to help me practice buat ayat because a lot of us tahu baca but tak tahu nak buat ayat. My first ever website was talktomeinkorean.com. So talktomeinkorean was like my first ever love. That makes Korean grammar seems easier because the explanation is like chef kiss, superb. English and Korean translation inside the website. Totome in Korean also has books, but I didn't purchase the books. I just used the basic package, which is all free. Last thing I did was to find online friends. It was MCO and I had nothing to do. It was holiday, so I thought I didn't what. I found HelloTalk. It's a language exchange app called HelloTalk. I think a lot of you guys already know about this. I also mentioned this a lot on my TikTok. HelloTalk ni best can find friends. Try to ask them if they want to exchange language with you. Some of them want to learn English, so you can exchange teaching language. We made group chat and I also call them a lot. We'll try calling them to ask how is our pronunciation. First, before ask them, kena tanya lah, kena kyohwan, can hasilleyo? If they say yes, then boleh lah. I think that's all. I'm not sure dah berapa banyak tips I cakap, but these are all what I did. Maybe a lot of you guys may ask, we need to do notes to learn a new language? Well, my answer is yes, but depends on yourself too. Are you willing to do notes every time? As for me, I don't. I don't really do notes now, but I did back then. So I'm gonna show you my old notes, like. These are the only notes that I did. Other than that, I just memorized it. Sometimes I just use my phone notes or my iPad notes. A new word that I found, then I just go to Papago or Naver Dictionary. Korean people pun guna Papago untuk Korean and English translation. Naver Dictionary pun diorang guna as dictionary English to Korean. I guess that's all for this video. I want to make it short. Maybe you guys will watch long videos, but this is my first talking video and I hope to do more videos in the future. 여러분 이 영상 재밌게 봤으면 좋겠고 앞으로 다른 영상에 보고 싶으면 like 많이 해주고 어떤 영상 보고 싶은지 댓글에서 남겨주세요. If you enjoy this video, please like, comment, share, and subscribe to motivate me to post the next video. Bye! Thank you for watching!